Hello everyone, I am Dr. Hitendra Patil. I am a consultant surgical oncologist, that is cancer surgeon. I have done my graduation from KEM hospital and post graduation in general surgery. I have done my super specialization in surgical oncology and then I have got few fellowships in the same fraternity. Today's topic of discussion is about endometrial cancer. Endometrium is nothing but the inner lining of the uterus. And the cancers of endometrium are rising very rapidly, especially in last 20 years. The pattern of endometrial cancer incidence is also changing, especially in the Indian continent as compared to the Western. We are often seeing endometrial cancers in early 40s, which were characteristically found in early 50s and onwards in the rest of the world. The endometrial cancer is predominantly a disease of young and fit population and is mainly increasing in our society because of the westernization of lifestyle. The increase in the hormonal agents that are being consumed, the obesity and lack of exercise. The endometrial cancer, when it occurs, it can occur in a normal endometrium or in something called as a polyp, which are pedunculated tumors in the endometrium. So the proliferation of this inner lining of uterus endometrium, when it occurs beyond the limit, it gets shaded on and off irrespective of menstruation. So patient gets intermenstrual bleeding, that means bleeding between the two cycles, and it is copious, it lasts longer than the usual number of days, and that warrants immediate attention. That is the chief symptom of this particular disorder. In case if the lady is postmenopausal, that means the periods have ceased, then when such lady gets bleeding per vagina, that is bleeding from the uterus, unless put otherwise, it has to be an endometrial cancer. This suspicion has to be always kept at the back of mind. How endometrial cancers are diagnosed? So the first test is a simple sonography in which the thickness of endometrium is assessed using an ultrasound. In postmenopausal women, anything more than 4 to 5 mm is highly significant and it has to be investigated. The endometrium, which is thick, which is found on a sonography, can be taken for a biopsy by simple office endometrial biopsy, which is a simple procedure which does not even require anesthesia. And a small piece of such thickened endometrium is taken and subjected to histopathological analysis. Whereas the earlier and standard method is a dilatation of curettage, in which the whole uterine inner lining is taken out and given for a sampling, and the detailed report by a pathologist gives an idea about whether there is cancer in the endometrium, what type of cancer of endometrium is there. Once endometrial cancer is diagnosed, we do something called as a staging workup, as to we try to find out which all places are involved by this particular cancer. It can spread to the adjacent lymph nodes in the pelvis, which is the first echelon of spread, and it may further spread into abdominal lymph nodes and then on to distant sites like liver, lungs or bones and whatnot. The mainstay of treatment in endometrial cancer is surgery. In surgery, the uterus along with both the fallopian tubes and ovaries are also removed. The first echelon lymph nodes are compulsorily removed in all cancers, and in certain high risk tumors or tumors which have bad prognostic indicator in the histopathology report, the abdominal, what we call scientifically as retroperitoneal lymph nodes, are also removed. So what are basically these lymph nodes, which are often talked about in cancer surgery and especially in the endometrial cancer? These lymph nodes are something like a police station. It traps all the infectious material, foreign material, cancer cells, some viruses and does not let it spread to the body. So if an individual has got cancer, it can be spread to the other different tissues, but the first filter lymph node is trapping it continuously. So we ought to remove this lymph node, subject it for histopathological analysis, so that we come to know whether the disease has reached to the first echelon or not. Depending on these findings, the pathologist gives us a staging of disease. That means there is a tumor stage and there is a nodal stage. The tumor, depending on its infiltration into the uterus, is staged as T1, 2, 3 and 4. And so also the nodes, they are staged as 1, 2 and 3. Depending on the tumor and the nodal stage, in cases where the tumor has not spread to the distant organ, that is non-metastatic disease, we come for a final part of the treatment, which is called as the adjuvant treatment. If this particular endometrial cancer has infiltrated or penetrated into the muscle layer of the uterus, then the tumors are divided into two parts. If the infiltration is less than 50%, that means less than half of the muscle layer involved, then such patients are usually observed. If it is more than 50%, then patient needs radiotherapy. In case the lymph nodes are involved, then along with radiation, patient will need chemotherapy. Let us not go into the intricacies of therapies. By and large, endometrial cancer require surgery, which is the mainstay of treatment and first line treatment, as well as radiation in few cases and chemotherapy in fewer cases, that is followed. Endometrial cancers usually have good prognosis unless it is a very bad or aggressive histological subtype, which is not so common condition. So we urge all ladies to come forward with the symptoms and get themselves tested and treated. All patients who have a family history, that means similar complaints or cancers in the family, or even for that matter different cancers like colonic cancer, breast cancer patients, also have to be vigilant in follow-up, and hereditary cancers also have to be ruled out. Endometrial cancer is highly treatable. Fortunately, they present in very early stages, and we all need to take advantage of this particular disease biology. We at Cure Hospital Rosa at Golbandar Road have all facilities for treatment of endometrial cancer. We can provide the radical surgeries for endometrial cancer, which can be even open or laparoscopic. We have all diagnostic facilities like endometrial office biopsy or even the dilatation and curettage, and the histopathological facilities are available here. And we request everyone to come forward and let us treat it at earliest possible stage and subject them for a cure than just a care. Thank you.